Welcome to DIY Solar and Wind. Today, I'm at Gilmore's Car Museum. If you want to make your own free electricity, click on the links down below so we can take your house off grid eventually through the years. I have 26 solar panels, and I'm doing really, really good with the electric bill. Today, we're at Gilmore's Car Museum. Today, this one is a 1954 Willy's Overland 4x4 pickup. All of these vehicles up here are amazing. They're just like right off the showroom floor. See this? It is. Probably can't get that in there. Right there. You can purchase this for $1,895. But this isn't 1954. Sheer engineering excellence. Company advertising. 115 horsepower. Willy's trucks are perhaps not nearly as well known as ambiguous, familiar Jeep or station wagon. Nevertheless, Willy's did produce a number of different truck models, including the pickup, stack bed and cab and chassis models. Willy's trucks made their debut in both 2- and 4-wheel drive configurations in May of 1947. The 2-wheel drive pickups were dropped after 1951. The pickup's design was updated and only slightly each year until mid-1950, when the flat grille was traded in for a more aggressive looking beat design, and the low dabble engine was replaced with the F head Hurricane engine. This particular example was acquired by its current owner in 1951 when it was found stored in an old barn near Orculo, Michigan. The vehicle remains in nearly all original condition, down to the interior and original seat covers. Basically, they didn't have any more components, and maybe one of the items on this truck had to be completely built for this particular vehicle. But that's how it is a lot of times. My stepdad loves the skidoos, the antique skidoos. He's got a couple of, if you can't find that component anywhere in the world, you got to get together with your engineering friends and just build it. That's to me, in my world, I still consider that all original. Because it was specifically made for that. I love this place. Just little tires. All right.